seated for the hymn.
Thank you.
scared of dentists and the dark. I was scared of pretty girls and starting conversations. All my friends are turning green. Yeah, the magician's assistant in their dream. Oh,
my most memorable moment from your year group was when I was pregnant, and I was quite heavily pregnant, about 24 weeks. You were all nudging each other, saying, "Is she pregnant? Is she not?" And you thought I couldn't hear, but I could. And I was laughing to myself, thinking, "When are you going to be brave enough to do it?" And I think one of you did. I think it might have been Lauren. You went, "Miss, do you have something to tell us?" And you all burst out laughing, which was very sweet. Also, I liked when I came back from maternity, you all came rushing to the RE office and were really excited to see me and really complimentary. So it was really nice. So thank you.
I think the most memorable moment has to be a certain lasagna incident involving some geography work and Ivana again, who managed to smear lasagna packed lunch all over her work to such an extent that we were sitting in the geography room and all we could smell was cold lasagna. We did wonder if poor Francis was going to be quite ill sat next to Ivana.
So most memorable recent moment is got to be Bella. When we were talking about compote, you'll have to ask her what we were talking about.
Okay, let me think. Okay, I think it's going to have to be the cheese string lesson. I don't think I've ever laughed that much in my life. I'm just going to leave it to that.
Well, the most memorable moment for me is when you all had the confidence to do an actual full swimming set.
Oh, there were so many, I don't think I can list them all, but one does spring to mind when I was zooming your lesson in year 10, first lockdown, I think, and I had a bit of a parcel left by my dog. Can you remember what it was? I showed you a picture of it. My dog, yep, he had decided to poo on the table underneath my Zoom lesson. And to prove, I showed my class a picture of the evidence. I never forget that.
And what about D of E?
Oh, D of E, yes. That had almost got completely left my mind. It's got to be the morning I woke up about 5 or 6 in the morning and I looked out the window and I saw a horse nibbling Maisie O'Shea's tent. And of course, the burnt pesto pasta.
My most memorable moment with Upper Five is introducing them to the theatre company Gecko, who are my favourite theatre company, and watching the joy when they came to see it at the Lighthouse, and also watching my class create Rumpelstiltskin.
Obviously, you're a year group that's been affected by lockdowns. One of my favourite moments, or series of moments, was when my son and my daughters got involved with our assemblies as a form group and were reading stories to the form group, and that was amazing because you guys were so kind and kind of encouraging them in that, which was brilliant, and really getting my family involved. Overhearing people, I overhear a lot of conversations in my form group, as you do in a room of people chatting, but one that sticks in the memory is both Maisie and Annie dreaming about Sinky Smith, Mr. Sinky Smith, you are dreamed about by my form members, to say, you know, just to weird you out on that one.
What I can remember about this group was happened on a Sunday when we had a full day's rehearsal. The girls were working very hard. I think I was working even harder. And I noticed a large delivery of McDonald's food. I was furious, not because they were eating McDonald's, but because where was my McFlurry?
Lots of memorable moments, mainly during the pandemic when I could see everyone's smiling faces keeping me going, but when you everybody showed me their pets. So lots of pets, and mainly someone having to excuse themselves from a lesson to go and help with some chickens. That's probably one of my most memorable moments.
Most memorable moment is definitely Betty's joke. I can't really remember much about it other than she made a really good impression of a peacock, which Lara laughed until she nearly split something.
Okay, probably hearing Lauren and Sienna talking about their potential boyfriends. quite a few actually, I won't name anybody.
Like everything. Well, I don't think I'm not gonna miss you for a day. Just too much, really.
Most memorable moment is at the beginning of year 11 when we were doing a practical of running and measuring our speeds to calculate our acceleration, and we were running down the entrance to the school to measure our speeds against the speedometer, and Bella fell over spectacularly. You know, legs and arms, bums everywhere. And she had only volunteered to do it twice so that she'd be a support for other people, but yeah, that was my most memorable moment. Thank you, Bella.
I've got lots of memorable moments. I've got Hattie and the Sheep, Annie and Harry, Molly and the Maps, Emily and the Rhymes, Betsy and the Wasp, and Honey and the Italian entry of the Eurovision Song Contest.
It was watching Lucy, Maisie, Elena, Helena and Darcy perform the Spanish play in the Linguistic Dinner. They were amazing. But I've got to mention this, is the best line I've ever got from Charlotte Paget told me during our Zoom lesson that Elle will be late because her sheep had escaped.
They've become one of the most hardworking, conscientious classes. An example of that is we have English every Friday afternoon, period 6, and they really work so hard, and they've come on. I'm really proud of them, and I'm really going to miss them.
I think the positivity and the enthusiasm of the Latin class, and you know, we had a lot of fun in our lesson.
I will miss coming in and for you to make me feel so lovely. You're like my youngest daughter who always says, "Mummy, you look so lovely." Well, you're the same lovely year 11s.
The thing that I'm going to miss the most is definitely going to be their sense of humour, even if it drives me crazy.
I will miss your ridiculous chats that I overhear, especially when you're doing practical, where you're always telling each other you're doing something wrong and you're blaming each other. And you're just really funny to eavesdrop on, if I'm honest. I really miss that.
What will I miss most? Regular updates about Star Wars and Marvel is a must. When Spider-Man No Way Home came out, that was pretty good. And long and wondering conversations about all things ethics and human rights over Zoom. I remember having a lesson plan and I was determined to get through it, but within about 30 seconds I think Helena Morn asked a question and that was the lesson gone, just discussing human rights, which I enjoyed, so I'm going to miss that.
Okay, I'm going to miss you probably every day. I've seen you every day for 4 years. We've been through lockdowns together, we've seen our pets, we've seen our homes, you've seen my daughter crying next to me in lockdown, you've helped me find the right flower when we were doing some bakes. I don't know how I'm gonna get through life without seeing you guys every day, to tell you the truth.
Okay, so like the thing I'm gonna miss most, without a doubt, is the chats that we have in lessons. I absolutely love having the chats, having fun, us all kind of camaraderie that we have, and just how amazing again you guys are at everything. So proud.
Well, there's a lot of things I'm going to miss, but I thought about this really carefully because I thought I can't say a million things, but I thought, do you know the thing I'm going to miss most is the smiles, because I have been so lucky with all of you. So I've taught a lot of you during the years, and the thing that I love the most is you come in with a lovely smile. Hi, Miss Barham. I see you in the corridor, hi Miss Barham. And honestly, your smiles, when you come through that door into room A or whatever room we're in, and you see me and you give me that smile, honestly, that is what I'm gonna miss the most.
I will miss the kindness, the generosity, and the laughs that I've had with my four wonderful Upper Five students.
I'm gonna say you are my favourite year. All of you, I remember lots of you from junior school, Annabelle, when she was probably, I'm not telling you about year four, year five, superstar PE person at the time, Maisie Cridland, the names go on and on and on, all of you, absolutely lovely girls, and yeah, gonna really miss your year group.
What will you miss? Your enthusiasm, your sense of fun, the fact that you're always smiling, keeping me going, and always cheerful. And it was really nice that you're all keen to welcome me back when I've been off ill recently, so that was really good.
Well, I'm glad you've asked. What you may or may not know is that I started Talbot Heath in September 2017. So my form group were my first upper three science group. Before I came here, I hadn't taught year seven for about 20 years. And suddenly I had these lunatic, tiny girls running about, causing chaos. Will I miss that? Maybe, I don't know, it changed things.
I will not miss one second of having to say, please unroll your skirt. Please take those four earrings out. Please tie your hair up. Or watching the people who come round a corner, spot me, and then start doing this and taking out various things and carry on past me and then put them all back in.
Probably some of the acts of sort of physical violence amongst the students in my class. You know, they often like to play fight with each other in our lessons, which can be quite frustrating when you're trying to teach.
Well, I miss the least. I get the speaker back. I don't have to deal with you lot in the morning. I don't have to shout at you lot anymore. I don't have to worry about you not doing anything, or you lot arguing with each other, or writing on the boards, get the board wet, not getting in, distracting everyone else, distracting the lessons.
Well, this is the most talkative he's been.
Things I will miss least. Miss least are iced coffee, turning up in full time. You know who you are. and left-handed geographers trying to suggest that I should retire at my right young age. You know who you are as well.
Wow. Where shall I start? I will miss Molly's special sound effects when she tries to speak Spanish. Trabaj. I will miss Lara's lack of imagination when she arrives late to lessons. Why are you late? Well, I don't have a reason, really. But finally, I will be missing Charlotte because she's a perfect one.
Nothing in particular, because I absolutely love my history group and I'm looking forward to seeing lots of them at A-level as well, but maybe more need some map skills.
I also would miss the fact that you girls have the smallest bladders apparently in living memory, have most of you having to go to the bathroom every couple of lessons. But really, you know, the things I will miss far outweigh the things that I won't miss.
The one thing I won't miss is when we have a bumblebee in the classroom and this class of utter mass geniuses all over suddenly fall into a complete wreck, screaming and shouting as if the world is on fire. I won't miss that.
So what won't I miss most about the year? To be honest with you, I'm going to miss everything. I mean, I know people will have said this already, but lockdown on you was tough. It was tough on everyone, and we kind of went through that together. We started a GCSE via Zoom, and you worked so hard, and you should be really proud of yourself. So I can't really say that there's anything I'm not going to miss. I just wish you all the best and that you can do really well in everything you've done, because you've learned so much through independent learning and all that kind of stuff. So well done, and I'm going to miss you all. Bye!
I can't believe it's been a year already, and I can't believe I'm still filming videos. Hopefully you enjoyed your GCSEs, and hopefully Signora Frati is not crying anymore after every lesson with you. Sending you all the best from sunny Spain.
Okay, I'd like to wish every member of Upper Five good luck in their all forthcoming GCSEs. You've triumphed over 2 years of COVID, 2 years of the pandemic, 2 years of lockdowns and restrictions. So 2 months of exams should be a walk in the park for you. And just to further inspire you, in the words of Captain America, the world does not shape us, we shape the world. So it's time for you to start shaping your world. And in the words of George Orwell in Animal Farm, forward comrades, to the golden future time. This is your chance, make your future golden. Do the best you can. And remember, the apocalypse is not the end of the world.
So this would be a typical TH needs assembly, like a long emotional speech from about 5 years of being seen before. I'll try to keep this one short and unemotional. Back in 2009, six little girls walked into Talbot Heath at the small age of three. Since then, the journey that Bella, Maisie, Lauren, Annabelle, V and myself have been on has been one filled with fantastic memories. From remembering when there was boys in the junior school to our more recent memories of ski trips, Mr. Kirtland, Sweet Caroline and of course, boys only. Indeed, little did we know how much of a positive impact Talbot Heath would have in school and make us into the guys we are today. Throughout the last 5 years, we have all experienced highs and lows, but by experiencing this together, it's brought everyone close and it's brought a meaning to attending TH today. Although after today, we'll be going our separate ways, I hope you remember the good memories that we have made together, and hopefully not the 574 marks that we've clocked up over the years. As a year group, we'd like to say a massive thank you to all the teachers at TH. You have made our time here the best possible. It's true to say, we wouldn't be here without the teachers. Even during the recent pandemic, you gave up countless hours to support us. You're true heroes and we can't thank you enough. We'd like to give the following messages of thanks. On behalf of Alpha Phi and Rumpy, we would also like to give a huge thank you to Mr. Thomas for putting up with our class for the last 2 years. Whether it's telling us or for sitting on the desks or forcing us to do corrects and staying enthusiastic, even though everyone lied to me, you always granted our day and set us off in a good mood for a period of time. However, we have to say that your dad jokes are still awful and you're still hopeless of getting assembly to work after 2 years. But despite this, you dealt with our banter, mood swings, breakdowns, and still supported us no matter what. Everyone has that one teacher they will always remember in their future, and that's you. You really have made our time at Talbot Heath so much easier, and we can't thank you enough for everything you've done and helped us with the past.
past years. We hope you know that you're an irreplaceable fortune, so we hope you feel the same about us as a full group. We're all going to miss you lots, and you truly are the best. Again, thank you for everything. I would like to say a few words on behalf of Upper Five Studio. We would like to say a massive thank you to our amazing form tutor, Mr. Butcher. During the 2 years we have spent together as a form, we have enjoyed every moment of it. From the countless nags of doing our CVs and personal statements, to the serenading around the classroom with the anonymous tambourine, your positivity and encouragement brightened our days. Mr. Butcher taught us to continue and pursue our dreams without compromising on small issues. This is one of the many lessons we have learned from him. I know all of my friends would like to share their words of gratitude with our loving teachers, as we as students have always been very grateful for you all, even if we don't share. It is our privilege to receive your guidance for our future. As we part our own ways and proceed with our lives, we will never forget the time we spent at Talbot Heath. And as Mr. Butcher would say, onwards comrades to our next chapter. To Mr. Kirtland, we want to thank you for all you've done for our class for the past 2 years. We were your first year 7 class you taught when you were first arrived in school to be head of science. You even told us almost every lesson that we would give you grey hairs, but we would neither confirm or deny if this has happened. Mr. Kirtland, I understand you may think we don't always listen to you, but we truly appreciate the motivational speeches you give us and how you never gave up on us as a class, despite our chaotic ways. I think I can speak for everyone in our class when I say you've impacted our school lives in different ways, even if it was something small as helping us with the science question. We hope you never give up your passion of acting or even one day become the weatherman, but either way, we will look for you on our TV screens. Thank you, Mr. Kirtland. You have been an amazing to us, and we hope you enjoy your well-deserved break, and hopefully your next class won't sit on the tables, but instead the chairs. From your upper three, five through pop. Absolutely amazing form tutors come up here to collect a few things.
Who's that? And the teacher said, that's her Holloway. And all the others here, Bella and a whole crowd, would say, that's not the head teacher, that's Francis's mummy. A number of these pupils here have been to birthday parties and all sorts of things right the way through, pre-prep, junior school, senior school. And you've always been professional, keeping that distance, and you've always been great, great fun and great characters. And all credit to you. It's been said by many staff today, but getting through those lockdowns and staying with that sense of humour and staying on track. And I was just commending Mrs. Stone this morning and saying that actually as a year group, you've just been preparing now for these assessments, and we wish you every success. And we're looking forward, I think we're going to have plenty of characters here in sixth form, so they're not all saying goodbye, and those who are heading to past is new, we wish you all the best and every happiness. So, I think our final task today is to wish the Upper Five the very best of luck for their GCSEs, and say have a super day.